Hello, in this video I'm going to show how to use the Harpifier Java library to create some Harpifier fire bundles. So let's start with an archetype taken from Adam Bean. So this should now generate the project in interactive mode. And we will take archetype 1. We'll take version 4. Then the group ID, it's als.eri, it's fire java demo. Let's take just the normal snapshot. Let's take the package. Yes. And now let's open this project in Visual Studio Code. Let's also just give it 1 second. Let's close this again and directly open it in the folder itself. So here. So normally Visual Studio Code should now detect that's a Java project, yeah, and it's detecting this. And now we have all these. We have the Java EE7 dependency. We won't need this one. What we will need is we will need the Harpifier dependency, the Maven dependency. And let's go here to documentation and search here for Maven users. And we will use the R4 structures. And actually, we only need the R4 structures. So these are the ones that we want to have. And project version, let's just search for these, for the newest version. So let's go to Maven repository, search here for the newest stable artifact version, search, sorry, and this says 5.0. Let's just try Google again. Okay, so it's 5.5.1. So that's the most recent release. 5.5.1. And what we will also do is we will add a test dependency. So junit.org user guide. And now let's use Maven dependencies, yeah, and we only need this dependency. I think all the others are not necessary. Okay, let's see what's happening here. Oh, it wants to have a version. Version 5.8.1. Version no parsable artifact group ID. Yeah, that's correct. Okay, so this all works. So now let's create a test folder. And now let's create a test harpy.harpy.test.java at test. No, there's public void test. So junit Jupyter engine. I think there is more what I need. Runtime version, image and balance version, platform launcher. Submit your project source. So this is currently wrong. It has to go here. Source main and then new Java, and then let's put it here. Okay. So now it works. Now we just created a test case, and now let's run the test case. And normally it should. So let's also get rid of this file here. And now let's try this again. Yeah, so it worked. And now we can work with the Happy Fire objects. So what we can do is we can just create a new bundle. And now, if you want this bundle to be a bundle of the KBV, you have to set the profile. And you do this in the way that you just do get meta and then set profile. And now here you have to use a list, just a list, canonical, what was the type? Let's just create this. And then new arrays as list. And I just check if I can just use canonical type, can just do this here. Makes sense. And there we have the URI that we can just put in here as a string. Let's double check what the profile name is. Simplify A-recept, then let's go to profiles. And we are interested in the ERP profile bundle, this one here. And this here, they already published the new version 1.0.2, and I think the correct way of doing this is like this. 1.2. So this is now how we define this bundle, and now we are also interested in seeing what this bundle is really how this bundle looks serialized, and we will just do this by getting a fire context. And then for version R4. And then let's just get a new JSON parser. So this is a iParser. This is the class parser. And then what we can do is we can just do an encode resource to string and then hand over the bundle here. And now if we run the test, we should see on the console the bundle itself. Here it is. So this is now the JSON way of doing it. And in the next video, I will speak more about other ways of doing it. Thanks a lot and see you in the next video.